So after Bhishma Dev departs, then Yudhishthir Maharaj goes back to Hastinapur and then he starts ruling from there. But then Yudhishthir Maharaj is still, you know, very unhappy that so many have died because of him. And Vyasadev at that time, he suggests, just like how he had done the Rajasuya Yajna, he should perform the Ashwamedha Yajna, the same thing that Lord Rama performed. Okay, so Vyasadev tells Yudhishthir Maharaj that he should perform Ashwamedha Yajna. And in the meantime, what happens is Lord Krishna, he departs. He goes back to Dwaraka. And then here Kunti Maharani, when Krishna is just about to leave from Hastinapur back to Dwaraka, at that time Kunti Maharani comes and stops Krishna very lovingly, affectionately, because she is the aunt. So she stops Krishna and then she tells that, oh Krishna, during all the miserable times that we had, you were there always with us, right? Always you were with us. When Bhima was poisoned, you were with us. When we were sent to the forest, you were with us. When the great asuras like Bakasura and so many others, at that time you were with us. When we were in the Lakshagraha, you were protecting us, you were with us. When we Draupadi's Swayamvara happened, you protected her. When my sons and Draupadi went to the forest, you protected. On the great ocean of the battlefield of Kurukshetra, you protected my sons. There were so many sharks like Bhishma, Karna, Kripa, Drona, all of them were like sharks. You protected my sons from them. So when you were, when we were having so many troubles, you were always around us, you were with us. Now everything is settled and it is a time for us to be peaceful and happy. You are leaving us and going. So that means only if there is some difficulty, you will be there with us. Then in that case, O Krishna, because I want to keep seeing you all the time, please give me those miseries, difficulties again and again. Because by looking at your lotus, beautiful lotus face every day, I will get out of this material world itself. I will not take birth again. So this is a beautiful verse that Kunti Maharani says, Vipada Santuta Shashvat Tatra Tatra Jagat Guru. She is telling Vipada Santu. Vipada means difficulties, you know, what to say, difficult situations like that. So many Vipadas, you are there always with us. And Kunti Maharani is praying, Tatra Tatra Jagat Guru. Oh, Jagat Guru, oh Krishna, please give those Vipadas again and again. Let them come back. Why? Because Vipada Santuta Shashvat Tatra Tatra Jagat Guru Bhavato Darshanam Yatsyat. Because if these miseries are there, only then you are going to stay with us. And Bhavato Darshanam, by having your darshan every day, A Punar Bhava Darshanam. Bhava means this material world. Punaha, again, I will not have darshan of this material world again. A Punar Bhava Darshanam. So therefore, please give those miseries again and again. Generally, when we go to God, we always tell, please, my dear God, you remove this difficulty, please, I don't have money, so remove my difficulty. This is what we pray, right? But then see here, one very exalted devotee is praying, let there be miseries, no problem, you be there with us, like that. How amazing this is, isn't it? So this is the difference between pure devotees, like the Pandavas, Kunti Maharani, Draupadi, and okay, devotees like us. You know, we go to God always with some contract, with some business proposal. My dear Lord, you give me this, I will give you this. I will give you laddu. I will give you coconut. I will break 108 coconuts. Like that, we do business with the Lord. But then, you know, the pure devotees, they want only one thing. They want the Lord to always be with them, either like personally or in the mind, that always they can remember the Lord. So this is one amazing thing that we can learn from what Kunti Maharani has prayed.